I'm used to working in Inventor, Autodesk Inventor. I've been doing quite a bit of designs in Inventor, and I love Inventor, but I see the value of using Fusion 360, but I've never used Fusion 360, so I thought this would be a really cool opportunity to show my thinking process and learning process for those of you that are not yet getting into Fusion 360 and you are using Inventor at this moment. So this would be a great video for people that are very new to Fusion 360, have really never seen it before, but are pretty good at using Inventor already. Inventor, I've been using Inventor, and I really don't know the benefits to Inventor over 360, but I do know that there is a huge benefit of Fusion 360 over Inventor, and that's the ability to put machining operations in your parts. So you can start creating all these really cool designs and with assembly of parts and things like that, and then you can take those parts and you can actually create the camming for those parts, you know, the machining operations. That then you can just take it straight from Fusion 360 and put it right into your control program for your CNC machine. I think that's a really great process. Before, we had to go into the Inventor, and we'd have to create the design, which is really cool. I love Inventor, and the way I design in it, it's very fluid, very easy. I love the constraints, the parametric aspects of it. But we had to take the Inventor files, we'd have to convert them into DXF, then we'd have to pass it into another CAM program like CAMBAM or Vectric software, and then we'd have to do all the machining operations in a completely separate program. And Fusion 360, you don't need to do that. You can just go right into to the model that you have in 360 and start camming the parts right there. And the really cool part about that is you don't have to go back into like the Inventor when you make a modification, then do that whole process all over again to go into the camming process. In Fusion, you make the changes in the parts, you know, any modifications, any dimensional modifications, and then all the camming and everything else stays, it modifies or parametrically modifies with the parts. So that is going to be a huge advantage. It's going to reduce a ton of labor on my side. So I'm going to show you in this video, I'm going to show you the benefits of using it and sort of my frustrations, if I have any, or my aha moments, or my general, like, wow, this is really very familiar to me because of Inventor, and maybe this is a little bit, this is something that I can't understand very well, and I figure I trudge my way through it, and you guys can take advantage of that that process and understand how these sort of processes work hand in hand, or how they are contrasted.
I'm so used to using Inventor, so it should be pretty easy to get into. So let's see my first attempts at Fusion 360. I like Fusion 360 because it has the ability to do the parametric drawing that I like, very similar to Inventor, but it also has camming abilities, which I want to really investigate. To make the manipulation of this canvas so fluid, I'm using the 3D mouse by 3D connection. It's a really nice way to manipulate the object. Okay, so I generally like things in the perspective, and it looks like it's already in perspective, so that's good. Let's see if I can put it back into orthographic here. Okay. Yeah, I can't really tell what's in front of me and what's behind me, so I'm going to go back to perspective. Actually, I think I like the perspective with ortho faces. Okay. So, I need to make an object or a part for a machine that I have that separates reels, reels as in tape and reels for for surface mount devices. So I'm going to start, and this video would probably be very good for people that are used to Inventor, because I'm coming right out of Inventor and I have zero experience with Fusion 360. So let's see what we can do here. Sketching looks like it would be the most appropriate thing to do, because I have a canvas here. So let's see. I need to draw some circles. So let's draw. Okay, I have several selections. It looks like it gives you the default of a rectangle. So I guess they think that we're going to be making rectangles all day. Circle, diameter circle, 2-point circle, 3-point circle, tangential circle, and then 3-tangent circle. So I'm going to just use a circle. It looks like it allows me to pick my face. I wonder which face I should pick. I don't think really. Okay, so I have the little indicator here of where I am. So I think XY would be the most appropriate. Since my machine is looking at the XY, I might as well do it this way. I'm guessing, so let's see what happens. So this looks like it's the positive X and the positive Y. Okay, so let's take a look here. All right, so I already have the circle. I need 5 circles. I'm gonna put them in arbitrary locations for right now. If this is anything like Inventor, I know I can do this. So I have to have 5 circles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and then I'm gonna have a circle that is they're gonna be connecting to. These are gonna be aligned along the edge of that circle. All these circles need to be a 1/4 inch. Actually, I need to have a couple more circles, one on the outside and then one on the inside. And I'm using this circle, but I can probably, I don't know what these are. We'll find out in a moment. Probably the other circles, centers. So let's see what we can do. In Inventor, we have these constraints, and I'm going to try using these constraints and to make these circles go along the edge of a circle. I would generally use the coincident constraint. So let's try that. That looks like it works. That works. Works. All right. And all these circles need to be of a particular diameter. So how would I change the diameter? Let's see. Can I right click it? No. Generally, there's a dimensional thing up here, but I don't see anything. So I'm going to go to sketch. Wait, create? No. It's definitely not into that. Modify? Nope. Assemble? Definitely not. Construct? Definitely not. Inspect? Nope. Insert? Make? Oh, there you go. That's pretty cool. Add-ins? No. Select? No. So I guess it would be under sketch. Sketch dimension. Here we go. Let's try this. All right. 0.25. Did I lose my dimensional? All right, let's try it again. Dimension. 0.25. 0.25. And 0.25. Okay, so these are all 1/4 inch holes. I may actually make them a little bit bigger. So you know what? I don't know why I did that. I don't want to dimension these because I want to make them equal to one specific one. So I'm going to make it equal. This one's going to be equal to this one. This one's going to be equal to this one. Okay, so press escape. So I should be able to change this, and all of them will change. All right, that's good. Now look at that, it has, I saw some interesting selections just a second ago. All right, so these circles have to be a certain distance away from each other, and 2.37, I'm working off of another model. So I'm gonna make these 0.27 so it fits with the rod that I have. All right, so I'm going to dimension. Look at that. There's a D. I guess I could use the D command. or the D keyboard shortcut. Okay, there we go. And it needs to be aligned. Okay, so that's the same as Inventor. So this will be 2.3794. I need to do the same thing for the rest of these. All right, let's see. I lost my dimension. Okay, so look at that. It's depending on where you are in this dimensional area, it'll actually give you the aligned or the non-aligned. That's cool. I guess I'm going to make this one equal to this one. That works well. So I'm going to dimension the next one. Let's see. You know, I'm going to try using the D keyboard command. See if that works. That worked. I pressed D and that worked. So I'm going to dimension this. See, you can see that it has, it automatically goes to this particular type of dimension, but if you move, it'll have an aligned dimension instead, depending on what you want, how you want to do it. Click this one. All right, let's see the next one. Oh, I could, let me just use that D. I probably could have done this by using a circular pattern like I do in Inventor, but I wanted to start out pretty simply and easily